All right, so everybody can hear us?
Test, test. You can hear me okay?
Does that podium mic work though?
Or? Yeah, we should
probably test that out. Or
may use it.
Hey!
Oh my God, Dr. Strangelove from Metal Gear Solid Peace Walker.
Here for RTX, let's play an intimate game.
Wait, this is like a Craigslist though. It's
Are
not.
Are you here this weekend for RTX? Enjoy playing games. Let's play our own game in your hotel room.
Hey, wait, no, we didn't post
it. Getting naked and seeing who can make each other come more times.
Oh.
I want to win. I am a 40 white male, 5'9".
Of course you are.
Brown, blue, goatee, attractive, intelligent, clean DDF, and a non-smoker. Let's play Friday night and or Saturday night. Tell me about yourself.
Get it? It's like let's play, like RTX.
Yeah.
That's getting into the spirit. Oh. So.
Thanks, Dr. Strangelove.
Thank you so much.
Yeah,
thank you, CherryDoom, my friend.
Yeah, you can please leave.
Get the hell out of here. Yeah. All right, the good stuff.
All right.
So, the past 2 years, I've started this panel by telling you a wacky story about a panel going wrong.
Right, okay, and but Slowbeef.
Slowbeef. Yes, yes.
I hate to interrupt your probably amazing anecdote.
Okay, which I didn't have.
I have this investment opportunity that I wanted to share with you and the whole room here and the people online while we're at it.
Let me get that wallet out.
Yeah. So let me ask you this. Have you heard of this? This guy approached me at the convention center telling me about this new company.
Yeah.
It's called Dahir InShot.
Dahir InShot?
Dahir InShot. Are you familiar with it?
They've been on our channel a couple of times, actually.
Oh, they have?
This guy, Ty Tuesday, and I made fun of them. He found them.
I don't watch videos I'm not in.
Yeah, I agree with that.
That's the policy.
Is anyone here not familiar with Dahir InShot, by the way? One, two, good. Okay.
A few people, okay.
Whew, okay,
well,
I don't feel so bad.
I happen to have this mashup of some of their, let's call it their product catalog.
We have is this Russian guy makes these computer animations of products that he wants to get capital investors to buy, but they're like really impractical or can't work for whatever reason. So we make fun of them. Mm-hmm. And here's like a quick 3-minute intro on them. For example,
into the store. The sales floor is divided into sections, each of which serves only one vehicle at a time.
I mean, so it works for fast food, so why not everything else you eat, right?
This is a supermarket you actually drive through. Signs,
the customer
okay.
drives up to a free section.
And they have a whole thing
racks of moving
upstairs where they literally stock the entire store in each and every aisle of it. So it basically becomes the world's easiest.
We've made this the easiest place to shoplift.
Absolutely, yeah. And if you get into an accident there, your whole supermarket's fucked. It's great.
What happens if there's like a line? Because then how do you get out of the store?
Because then it's called traffic, right? In your grocery shopping experience.
You swallow all the carbon monoxide and die.
Now you say, yeah. That's okay idea. It's not terrible. Whatever. Okay, let's keep going though.
Once it reaches the obstructed area,
what shelf is this on?
No, this is a different one. This is a different product.
It fixes itself in place using clamps.
Ah.
It then expands pressurized tanks that prevent blood flow. If necessary,
this is supposed to get rid of cholesterol, but it ends up blocking your arteries, killing you. And then it puts a little tiny thresher in. To your fucking veins, mind you.
It looks like it shaves the veins as well.
Yeah.
I mean, you can sand wood. Why not cholesterol?
I just use a little bike lock thing. Right. Now,
okay.
You know, that in real life, that would kill you, and it wouldn't work at all.
Mm-hmm.
But this next one is where we knew that the here and show. This is where you really want to get your wallets out, okay?
Yeah.
What if there's an earthquake?
The main causes of death during an earthquake is the...
I mean, a very... Very isolated earthquake.
Like this tree,
I mean,
the tree lamps are fine.
It's a very environmentally aware earthquake.
These three buildings that are exactly the same are not so fine, though, maybe,
mm-hmm.
right?
Right, right.
The earthquake happens while people are asleep.
And you're asleep in the day, but still.
Right. Breaking news.
Dahir InShot has developed the earthquake safety bed,
okay.
which instantly transforms into a shelter during the first underground tremors of an earthquake. Let's see.
Yeah, because... Because why shouldn't your bed be a tomb, right?
You get to sleep in a Dark Souls mimic. It's great.
Yeah. It's more of a garbage chute than a bed.
Now my favorite one. Okay. So you look over, you say, hey, that's a fruit truck, right? No problem.
I would love some fresh fruits.
Yeah. And you say, well, what product involves that? So let's use our iPad app here to transform our fruit truck, of course. Oh, wait.
So I guess I'm not getting fresh fruit?
No, now here's the problem you're trying to solve. Let's say there's an enemy airbase.
I mean, you as a customer commonly have this problem.
Right, just tens of thousands of planes about to scramble. How can your fruit truck help you with this?
What are you going
to
do?
And you might say, why did the people selling like groceries and all that have military applications too? I don't know.
And also, why couldn't they get a guy to pick them up?
Right. No, it comes with two escape copters. All right. So you say, okay, well, is that like a little tomahawk thing? No, no. Look,
I've heard of stretch goals, but
oh. So what happens is this becomes a giant quadcopter, kind of like a cute little drone you'd fly in the park, right, only with missiles and a Gatling gun.
So this fires the fresh fruit to needy places? Is that how it works?
Not quite.
Oh, no?
No. It fires, I guess, 250-pound iron bombs.
You point vaguely in the direction of the enemy base, and
it just destroys the entire enemy base. Congratulations.
That pilot seems okay with it, though.
Yeah, no, he's fine.
He's like,
honestly,
I mean, that was bound to happen.
Oh, wait.
Now you were telling me that this is actually completely illegal. Like, it's anti-Geneva Convention.
This is not a lie. Someone in our comments pointed this out. We looked it up. This is a war crime. You can't actually make, like, military shit look like civilian shit because it encourages people to buy military.
So it looks a little less like civilian shit if you title your truck something like time freshness, delivery of fresh water.
Right. Now it's implausible. So that's how they get
it. And the fresh water is ice that they deliver instead?
And you might notice, too, that there's, like, other trucks arranged around this one. And you might wonder why. And the answer is, fuck that quadcopter from before. We're going to make some Voltron fucking shit right now.
Quadruple the quadcopter.
Absolutely, yes. Yeah. It's just, and you think, does it make four quadcopters? No, just one giant quadcopter. And this is, by the way, like a 5-minute video. It takes them a while to assemble it, but
meanwhile, the enemy base is completely left.
Yeah, exactly.
No one there.
And it's funny that the air base can't fight, like, one quadcopter, but, you know, that's the here and shot difference for you.
So, okay, so you take your arsenal up in the air, and then, really, before you even
just
settle, just start firing.
Just straight up into the air,
Just don't really aim. Just let it loose. And then,
goodbye, aircraft carrier.
The aircraft carrier's gone.
All right.
The end. So,
this is a whole series we have on our channel.
Right. So, I mean, I see all of you have your wallets out, and people at home as well.
We do have a new video from Dehiren
Shot. If you're not sold yet,
right,
this might tip you.
Right. Whose water is this? Can I drink? No. Okay. So, all right. So this is a totally new video now, okay?
Okay.
It's not the plane. They're not selling that. What'd you say?
This assumes you already own a plane.
Right, exactly. A big cargo
plane.
Or
several planes.
And with fighter escorts. Right.
So you have several planes, you got a box of missiles that you need to drop off somewhere.
Right. So you say, okay, is this,
All right, I got a box of missiles for a Mr. Smith.
just drop them.
Should I take them to you, or, I'll just drop them off. It's fine. Yeah.
So this is very calm zen death and destruction here.
I assume you can catch all these.
Multiple configurations, by the way.
Yeah.
And not, your own pattern.
Not wireless yet. They don't have that technology.
No, it has to be tethered to the actual missile box for some reason.
All right, but
that wasn't even the product. That's just an extra thing.
But wait, there's more. Buy the box of missiles, you get the solar panels for free.
Yes. Now we're going to drop solar panels.
Well, solar panels that have camouflage on them?
With a twist, right. So, okay, so you've bombed the shit out of this
country. That guy has no idea what he's doing.
Okay, so we have these parachuting, you know, solar panels and such.
So I gotta ask, what happens if the parachute lands on top of the solar panel?
That's a good question. Now watch closely. What happens is,
okay, so there's some kind of
the video cuts and then the solar panel just out of the way. And now you say, okay, what the hell is this?
Is it a treadmill?
It just cleans up after itself.
Yeah, it's got reverse diarrhea technology.
Very eco-friendly, whatever this is.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, all right, so the solar panels are now useless.
Right. And also, this comes from literally nowhere. This just appears, this thing. But, okay.
And what happened to all the missiles that got dropped?
Oh, that's back in another country or something. This is a second thing.
Okay.
Okay.
So what's cool is if you're 30,000 feet in the air, you can't see them.
You'll never see these things. It's great. So you're probably wondering.
So where is Waldo's solar panel?
And what is this for? Like what? Well, here's the thing. So let's just say, hypothetically,
right,
you have a lot of money and you're, I guess, have a, what is it, 3-2, wait, we'll just zoom on this.
Mm-hmm.
So let's say you have,
it's still there.
What is it? What's the problem you're trying to solve here? Oh, right. An enemy tank battalion.
Oh, right. Yeah. There's a very lost tank battalion.
And you know exactly when and where they're going to be, well in advance, so you can bomb straight ahead, have your solar panel things high.
They somehow didn't notice your plane dropping everything off.
Right. And just in case there's a predator drone, I don't know what this adds to the video, but it's here.
It can't see them unless they try.
Right. And then it's revealed.
And then, like, all right, forget the camouflage.
And what is this, you ask? It's a this.
So,
I don't know if you knew this, but bullets, missiles, you don't need to fire them with cannons. You just hold them up and they just sail away on their own.
It's called solar power, Slowbeef. It's clean energy.
And they don't even know what they're firing at. It's great.
And then this guy,
he just shoots off to the left somewhere. He's like, what the fuck? I can't deal with this.
Y'all got the rest of this covered. I know.
So, I don't know what this product is called, but apparently it's available, and I'm making air quotes here.
It's called the future.
So I heard someone in the crowd ask, what do the solar panels do? Fuck if I know.
They make the missiles go.
I guess, yeah, they provide power.
So to hear InShot primarily focuses on the bustling marketplaces of military-grade weaponry.
Yes. Medical things.
Medical stuff, earthquake safety,
yep.
And groceries.
Groceries, too.
Yeah, okay.
And restaurant technology.
That's pretty comprehensive, yeah.
It's a spread market.
They have something for everyone.
Yes.
Impressive.
They do. Now, let's go to the exciting part.
Yeah, tradition of these panels is the most exciting part, the slides.
Yeah, no, this is the part everyone
loves.
Can
I get a little applause for the slides, please?
Yeah, we got it.
Thank you. I mean,
we call that an 11-minute cold open. Yeah. Is that a vuvuzela or whatever the fuck that is in the 90s? I thought I heard one.
Thank you.
Okay, so
we obviously worked very hard on these. The hashing tag RP at RTX 2016.
This doesn't work on Twitter, by the way, yeah. So don't do it. But, you know, it's there.
A little something special. We got polygons.
Absolutely.
On the slide template this year.
It's beautiful. It was the first thing I found in Google, slide template.
Don't say
or
that.
Whatever. Who are we?
Yeah.
You, Diabetus, spelled wrong outside, is the creator of the infamous Captain Novel in Let's Play. Co-host of this YouTube channel panel, actually.
Yeah.
And the one everyone likes.
Yeah, I've learned to accept
that. I'm kind of the dick.
It's the heavy burden. I bear it.
I am also here.
Misspelled your name, but it wound up being mine that was spelled incorrectly.
You know what's funny? I wrote this slide, too. I had no excuse.
Yeah.
No.
You wrote the slide.
Sorry,
you put a lot of creative effort went into this.
I painted everything.
So, some corrections. We like to look back at the past panels and see what we did wrong, what we can improve the following year. So what do we have?
Okay, we have...
So, yeah.
We didn't do the lighting things that we did last year, so...
I mean, there was this amazing Kickstarter that had this really detailed table that no one could read, unfortunately.
I'm so sorry.
Yeah.
I couldn't figure out how to resize the image, so it's just lower.
We put these slides together 2 minutes ago.
Did everybody see the Dahir InShot video okay, by the way? Do we need to lower them? Okay, good. All right.
We wouldn't have done anything if anyone had said no. So
yeah, it's a good thing.
I mean...
Splatoon!
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 Speaking of Splatoon...
Just move on from that real quick.
So, since the... Don't go back to that, please. So, since the last panel, we did finish the Sonic 2006 thing.
And
it felt like 2003.
Yeah.
And we just wanted to... We threw it in the trash of the panel last year, and we... It belongs there.
1 year later, yeah, no, still not a good game.
More of an affirmation than a correction.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Okay, what are we going to do with this panel?
All right.
Done.
Done,
yes.
Call me.
Done. We have it, okay.
Might want to expound, I don't know.
Oh, we're not doing the fourth thing. Let's just do the up. Okay. Delivering content.
We've been running on fumes for quite some time.
I agree. This panel, even? Okay.
Content.
Yep. Make RTX regret inviting us for the third consecutive year. I think we're there.
We've done
right?
it 2 years so far. We're running strong.
I'm looking over at The Guardian. He's just like smiling, like, yeah.
He's doing like doing a throat slash thing.
Get them the fuck out
of
here.
Yeah.
Where's Mike Jones? Get him in here. And then give more free advertising to big PowerPoint.
Yeah.
So.
It's more big Google Docs.
Done and done.
Too lazy for PowerPoint?
Yes. Now that that's over with.
All right. So for those of you not. As aware of the channel as others. So we started off making fun of Let's Plays. Once that kind of got kind of stale, moved on to like Flash games, long plays of video games. But the new hotness seems to be these crowdfunding videos.
Right.
Have you guys heard of Kickstarter?
And Indiegogo and
Indiegogo.
Such? We started making a series, Kickstarter, non-starters.
Yeah, so
like
people
that.
Like may make a game in RPG Maker and figure, I should have $1,000 for this. Yeah. Or I have this Nazi anime girl card game that I think would be a great idea.
And they funded that one, like, a lot.
Yeah, by a lot.
I was surprised for the Nazi anime girl card market.
So what's, like, the next step in crowdfunding beyond those things? Well, we think we found something, and...
I'm gonna give you a content warning.
Yeah.
This is fucked up.
And not, there's no, like, nudity, violence, or anything.
No, not for the usual reasons. I just want to tell you, this is fucked up.
It's weird.
Yeah, we had a lot of requests to do this one.
Yeah, so
we're doing it live.
Take it away.
All right. Hey, it's Paul from paulsalo.com.
Hi, Paul.
And today we have a very exciting project.
What do you got, Paul?
If you want to be a part of this, if you are a 9/11 denier.
Oh.
I shouldn't use the word denier.
Well, that took less than 20 seconds.
Anything about 9/11. We want to blast this to smithereens.
Oh, the phrase.
Maybe watch the metaphors there. What's kind of unsettling about this, he smiles throughout the entire video.
He is super excited about this project.
Very.
Purchase a 747.
Oh, don't do it.
Equivalent aircraft.
Yeah.
That is about to go out of service. We're going to fill it full of jet fuel.
Oh, no.
Go on.
We're purchasing a building that's about to be torn down. We're here in Thailand right now. And we've talked to the Thai military.
He told the Thai military, I want to buy a plane and throw it into one of your buildings.
We don't have anything 100%
set. And they were like, sure.
What we're going to do is we're going to purchase a building that's about to be torn down in the countryside.
You know all those skyscrapers in the countryside you can go through?
Yeah.
Yeah.
A loaded airplane, and we're going to crash it. At 500 miles
and I really want to punch him with how fucking happy he is over this. Just will not stop with those giant teeth.
Do you think he's working with Tahir Inshot on this?
What's going to happen to the steel? What's going to happen to the aircraft? We're going to put...
I don't know why they filmed it like on the side of this river or anything like that.
Yeah. Passports.
Oh, and here's the plane he's using.
Yeah, and then they cut to a boat. Yeah, sure, why not?
You're welcome to come to this event. Okay, so you can come with your camera. You can film anything you want. We're gonna put GoPros all over inside the building.
Just like in 9/11.
All over inside the GoPros. Airplane.
How are you gonna recover GoPros from a fucking plane you crash into a building?
I think he's gonna put GoPros on the GoPros.
Oh, I see.
What we're gonna do here is we're gonna prove once and for all. Was 9/11 a hoax?
Was 9/11 a hoax?
I think I don't
obviously
know.
Obviously, we can't go back in time and make that happen. But
I can't go back in time, so the next best thing I'm going to do is just recreate a terrible event.
This is the most practical thing we can come up with.
And he wants you to give him money to do it.
My favorite part.
Right.
Flying into a building at 500 miles an hour. And what happens to that building is going to tell us a lot about what happened.
It's going to be exactly like 9/11, except different planes, different buildings.
Yeah, different,
Yeah, really everything.
It's pretty much very instructive.
Because it's obvious, right? And if the building, has similar physics as 9/11, when the building was, it looked like there was explosives.
He's making this up as he goes along.
It was really an airplane, right? We're going to see.
Oh, it was really an airplane?
Many doubt that there were airplanes involved on that terrible.
I think he's projecting a little bit. He says a lot of many people think that.
And you want to prove this once and for all, donate to this project. If you don't believe in 9/11.
If you believe in 9/11, share's other.
Say 9/11 three times in front of the mirror.
This was a major fraud perpetrated upon the world to start the war on terror. You want to give us money too.
I don't.
Try to do this as cheaply as possible.
As cheaply as possible. The budget 9/11 is what we're looking for here.
We're willing to go to any country for this. Okay, so if we have to go to Africa, if we have to go to South America, it doesn't matter. If we
can Antarctica, whatever.
Here's a shot of people who didn't ask to be in the video. We're just going to focus on them. I feel really bad for this girl in the front because then she notices, like, let me get the fuck out of here.
What he's talking about is messed up.
I don't want anything to do with this.
My basic viewpoint is I think what's going to happen is that we probably will find out that it was a similar physics.
I think we'll find the laws of physics hold across time and space. Yes, that's...
But in Thailand, too?
But at the same time, hey, I'm no dummy. And maybe it's not true. I mean, I want to find out, too.
I mean, I don't know, but, you know...
I mean, I know so many people doubt it.
Find out exactly what happens when something goes 500 miles an hour into a building full of fuel. So we're going to try to recreate it.
He does it on autopilot, is what he says.
Okay, this is an open discussion.
Oh, it's an open discussion? Well, maybe don't do it. How'd that sound?
It's an idea. Anything you want to add to the project.
You know, any kind of zany doodads you want to include with my project.
Okay, we're going to try to do it for $300,000.
So he says $300,000, but on his page, $1.5 million, maybe?
You know, either way, it's close. I can see how you make that mistake.
We're flexible.
The only thing I say is we absolutely have to have a working black box.
Okay.
All right, working black box.
It can't be an airplane with no black box. So I want a black box. That's absolutely cannot be. That's non-negotiable.
So he's talking to the Thai military. He says, "All right, okay. I'll give you the plane. I'll give you the building, but I can't give you the black box." And that all walks.
That's non-negotiable. Who the fuck is negotiating with him about this anyway?
With these physics.
The mirror.
And I personally, a lot of my friends said, "What's going to happen? Aren't you worried about?"
All my friends said, "Please don't talk to me anymore."
Upset by this, I'm not worried at all.
You should be more worried about people laughing at you, Paul.
I want to make sure that comes through. Right. That one.
Hey, look, you deserve it.
We deserve it.
This is another. I mean, phrasing. Phrasing.
It's never happened before.
So no, one time it did.
Remember the thing you're trying to recreate, Paul?
What happens when this occurs? So I'm going to give you this.
Weirdo.
It's a one-time thing. Donate to the project, and your name will be on there, and you'll also
your name will be on what, the building?
Any concepts you have, if you want to add a camera, if you want to be a guard at the building.
I don't want to be a guard at the building.
Why does he need a guard? Does he have competition trying to do this as well?
Wait, what the fuck is this? Why are you showing me a Thailand market?
We're going to show you this delicious food to whet your appetite for some meaningless destruction.
Why did he voice over this? He's saying, add the footage of the market. That really helps us.
We're
going to
run into some issues, right? And we obviously need a lot of firemen around because there could be a huge fire.
I mean, there could be a fire.
We're going to use autopilot, okay? Autopilot.
Yeah, because you know how planes don't even need
like someone to turn on the autopilot.
They just walk out.
We're going to use autopilot. And somebody said, what if you miss the building? If we miss the building, obviously
Paul,
that sucks.
Paul, your project seems to be. I have one question.
Wait a minute.
We're in a good position.
Yeah. What happens
sucks,
if
we... But we're going to buy another plane and do it again.
All right, wait.
If we miss the building, obviously that sucks. But we're going to buy another plane and do it again. Okay.
If we miss the building, that sucks. For whatever else we hit, yeah.
I mean, I am really enticed to donate to him with that level of confidence.
That's a real downer.
I mean, if it misses, it might hit some other equally acceptable building.
The airplane goes sailing, whatever.
It'll work itself out.
Yeah.
It could be more, but we're going to do our best. And if that's true, we'll keep you updated and we'll let you know as things go.
Thanks.
So again,
Paul.
This is Paul Sanders, a very exciting project. You're going to find out once and for all what the heck was going on at 9/11.
We know, Paul!
What the heck?
We know!
We don't have numerous attempts at this, so we're going to go for the
No, no one. Shit, you don't have numerous attempts at it. You're not going to have one!
With a similar structure to the
A similar skyscraper in the country,
yeah.
Right?
A similar structure to the World Trade Center in the Thailand countryside. I mean, it's teeming with
The same way they entered. We're going to try to recreate as much as we can. Right? And we don't care what anybody thinks.
Obviously.
If we have to go somewhere else and shoot this thing in private, we're going to shoot it.
You know, of all the concerns you have, I don't think privacy... Right?
Yeah, how are you going to make that in private? It's like, don't look behind this giant screen I have.
9/11 Part 2, it's going to happen right here. PaulSaylor.com. So thanks so much for watching.
So fucking creepy.
And I appreciate you giving some money because...
He's got his shirt unbuttoned like he's trying to use his raw sexuality to help sell the project.
For an extra $100,000, maybe the second button comes off.
You never know.
Maybe the whole polo, Thailand?
I'm a serious guy. We're going to do whatever kind of negotiations we need to do to get these planes, okay? If it's not legal in one country, we're going to another because we're going to make it happen.
All right.
Thanks for joining in. I appreciate any kind of
And there's one part at the end I just want you to see right here.
And I appreciate your belief and trust to watch this. Yeah? I think this is going to be the hottest video of 2017.
He's going
to
make it a YouTube video, ultimately.
The viral sensation.
Exactly. Without PewDiePie.
Right.
September fucking 11th.
So, oddly enough, this page is no longer up, not because Indiegogo took it down, but Paul himself was like, you know, I should go back to the drawing board on this.
Yeah, he wrote a thing like, I'm going to retool this idea a little bit.
Right.
But in the time it was up, out of the 1.5 million he needed, 55.
So you could buy like a toy plane, build a building of Legos, maybe.
Yeah, you know, on your way. That's fine.
Something like that.
How could you not donate with a concise title like "We will prove 9/11 to be true and false once and for all"?
Like how the plug for his website is beneath a burning plane.
Yeah, what the fuck?
That's
what an asshole.
It's oddly fitting.
I'm sure you do. I'm sure he's.
You get to turn on the autopilot. I think.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Okay.
All right, so of course there are goals,
yeah,
reward tiers.
You're a free thinker. 25 a supporter. $125, you get a t-shirt, 9/11 the Redux.
So aside from the fact that I'm paying $125 for a t-shirt, you know, it's a great conversation piece. Going to just go to Manhattan wearing this shirt, meet some people.
9/11
I'm sure they would get a kick out of that.
We are like a Mythbusters for September 11th. I'm pretty sure the Mythbusters don't do anything.
That's a real season finale kind of thing, isn't it? On a very special.
Let's read the next page here. What you need and what you get.
So, Slowbeef, if I give $1,000,
okay,
what can I expect in return?
A piece of the rubble. A great conversation piece.
Hey, Slowbeef, I couldn't help but notice on your mantle you have some dirt.
Oh, this rock?
What is that?
I paid $1,000 for some weirdo to redo September 11th.
Ah, very interesting. Clink. Toast. Great conversation piece. So for $5,000...
Oh, wait, before that, though, if they don't reach their goal, they'll get a smaller plane and building. Either way, we're going to learn a heck of a lot.
I mean, they're only going to kind of half-ass the scientific method here.
Yeah, why not?
Yeah.
But for $5,000, front row seat.
For $5,000, you get put in imminent danger. Congratulations.
Fantastic networking opportunity.
Right.
No, I don't think so. Oh, by the way, for $5,000, though, you must still purchase ticket and hotel accommodation.
Of course, yeah.
I'm sorry.
There are limits.
The impact. He started several difficult products in Asia, including a real estate company in China. How about that?
So it's a logical next step.
Yeah, no, very qualified
absolutely.
For this. So many people are contacting me. Experts. Serious.
Mm-hmm.
Ready to act. Open-minded. Looking for truth. Stretching their limits. Sentence fragments.
Even the way he words stuff is creepy alongside with his constant sneering smile.
That's what we want. More of that.
Yeah.
And you. So, and what's the biggest risk and challenge to a project like this besides, like, fucking everything?
One of the biggest challenges is the total respect he has for the firefighters and police that gave their lives. Yeah,
that's very challenging.
He'll overcome that challenge and make this happen.
Yeah, no, I'm very glad he did. Thanks for nothing, Paul. So,
what a weirdo.
That's that Kickstarter. I'm very glad we got to bring the panel to a screeching halt with some really heavy September 11th.
So for those of you still in the room,
yes,
we're going to go to some familiar territory. There's an old friend. For those of you who saw our MagFest panel, there was a special friend of the show that we covered extensively there. One, George Wood.
You may have heard of.
Navigator, gaming in the Clinton years.
Is anybody not familiar Navigator, George Wood? If you're not...
Someone told us that a person at the Navigator booth was actually going to be at the panel.
I heard that, but
is it that person
I think they
here?
Left during the September 11th show. Oh, no, here he is. Okay, hey. Cool. Hey, how are you?
How's George doing?
Yeah. Good, okay.
Where is he?
Oh. Just in his underwear and stuff. Yeah. So we have a George Wood video we never did before. But before that, just again, for anybody who's not familiar, just a real quick
like, we split into smaller and smaller bubbles.
So this is a couple of videos or whatever, but
so for just those of you who don't know what his style of reviewing stuff is, this should give you a little taste.
Right, this is a review of Buster Brothers for the PlayStation.
Which must also be busted. Sounds crazy?
No.
It is. Just like Tetris.
Tetris
Buster Buddies
crazy
includes
either,
famous paintings and works of art.
Did he just
like
wake up?
Shown here. These works serve as backdrops for each level. Being the silly people that we are, we were kind of hoping to see mannequin piss in the background.
Mannequin piss?
Yeah, no, just so you don't miss it, he just hits puberty all of a sudden right
hoping
there.
Hoping to see mannequin piss in the background. Man, wouldn't that be cool?
You don't need to zoom in, George,
please.
It's
a true
please.
Famous work of art.
George,
why not?
Stop.
Anyway, no amount of urine can make this game viable.
that's the tagline for the review.
Yeah, the review ends on that.
Right. So this is, he made it a review of Final Fantasy VII that his fans hated, and he decided he had to have a rebuttal. He needed the last word on Final Fantasy VII, so.
Now,
to the haters.
Regarding the gameplay, Final Fantasy VII is no different from the series' last game in terms of execution. No one has refuted
I can't help but
that.
Realize how much Final Fantasy
Instead,
VI I was playing.
Yeah, it's totally
quo,
the same.
Saying, that's what you do in RPGs.
Oh,
if that's the
George.
Case, if we shouldn't demand increasingly more involved gameplay, then we also shouldn't demand any new video game systems.
He's so mad.
Let's never ask for anything more than Pac-Man, because hey, that's all you do in video games. Eat dots.
No one said that.
He sounded like he was holding back so much anger and tears.
And I'll point out to you, if you're going to say, hey, this game has the same gameplay as the previous game, maybe don't show a totally different scene of gameplay from the point you're making.
But okay. Never ask for anything more than Pac-Man, because hey, that's all you do in video games.
What a neat dot.
Donkey Kong Country is truly perfect. If you do not get this amazing new generation of Donkey Kong madness, you are stupid. Yes, I know, that's insulting, but it's also the truth.
There it is.
If you're a true video game fan, you will not hesitate in the slightest bit to buy this remarkable piece of video game history.
And what a better way to review games than to alienate your audience?
Right.
Really.
Speaking of alienating your audience, so.
Right. So
let me explain this, because we're not going to do the. At one point, he had a public access show, and he decided to
branch off into game shows, because why not?
Right. This is called Who Wants to See My Derriere, and the gimmick. Well, you'll see.
We have a new format this year. It's a game show, a show within a show. It's affectionately called Who Wants to See My...
And it's censored for some reason, but... He has the world's biggest headset, and the notion is he gets a kid on, and he asks him video game questions. If the kid gets 10 right, he'll show the kid his ass.
And they run with that premise throughout the whole thing.
And he gets lifelines, like, you know, phone a friend, but they're all bits he wants to do. The problem is he didn't script it or anything.
Yeah, so Sean knows the answers to most of the questions. And
right.
So here, they're getting near the end, and George really wants Sean to use his lifeline so he can do his hilarious bit where he calls his mom.
Right.
Or Sean calls his mom.
On Snap is closest to which of the following experiences? Riding a roller coaster?
These laptops serve no purpose, by the way.
Riding on Howard Lincoln? Or collecting and training lick stamps? Think first and think hard. This is the answer.
Think first.
Is it B? Riding on a safari?
Or riding lick stamps?
Oh, well, before you answer, you might want to use your two remaining phone calls. Unless you're absolutely
sure. What a good host, right?
I'm absolutely sure. B.
George, shut up.
He's absolutely sure? And the answer is B, riding on safari. Wow!
little mini stroke there at the end, but okay.
So let me tell you about this show. He had multiple seasons of this. Right. At one point, they even changed out hosts. So they really believed in let's show this kid our ass.
This show went on for seasons, multiple seasons.
But this season in particular, they changed things up a bit.
Right.
Glad they included this part of it.
So they have George's evil twin brother.
Welcome to this edition of FOFTV.com, where we play the game, Who Wants to Go Back to Cuba?
Is he
okay?
What?
Are you ready to play the game?
So this is Guido, that's his actual
here's
name.
The first question.
Poor Abercrombie.
Sheila Belkin thinks everyone is sexy.
I don't know what that was, but...
Which of the following hunks
he did a little dark side
pill
there.
Definitely the sexiest. Is it Jack Faber, A, B,
now, notice, too, they have all sorts of post-production and things like that, multiple camera angles, but this part...
Well, you better fix your mic, Guido. Nobody's going to hear you.
This goes on for a bit. They can't edit it or anything. They're just like, no, leave it in. Fuck it.
It's hard to cut to commercial when you have no advertisers.
That's true, too, actually, yeah.
You have to know what you're doing.
So, we were thinking of doing this video for this panel, but this is really fucking out there, and...
It's like 11 minutes of, what?
Yeah, and he has two contestants he just cycles through as they get wrong.
The real answer is D. Juan Miguel Gonzalez. That's what you get for losing.
They call him One Take Wood.
Darn. Right.
So, and why is George dressed like Satan's assistant?
I'm not sure, honestly. But we're going to end on a new George Wood video here.
Right.
One we never did before. We just missed it, basically.
It's like a hints guide?
This is George Wood's strategy guide. There's a navigator plug for you. To Super Metroid.
My favorite power-up is always the screw attack.
I missed your Bill Clinton.
I really love screwing.
I get it now.
It's good.
I know. Thank you.
Thank you.
It seems like it's been forever, but it's only been a year since the mighty Super Metroid graced
the
Super
NES. Wow, he is terrible. Metroid.
If you haven't been able,
I know, he has kind of balls to give me strategy guidance for it.
We're going to give you all the info you need to kick some alien butt.
Just as soon as I get out of the room.
The first step to beating this game is to get the Super Metroid Player's Guide from Nintendo.
Okay, hang on a second. Okay, so...
Did everybody hear that? That was step one.
So step one, you put on this video for your strategy guide.
Step to beating this game is to get... The Super Metroid Player's Guide from Nintendo.
So stop the video, go buy a different strategy guide.
And use it here.
And use that strategy guide. I guess video over, right?
Yeah, pretty much. Oh.
Carefully and follow the steps shown on the last page. Your first problem should be getting the spring ball.
Isn't there stuff before Meridia and Metroid?
No, this is where the game starts. It's fine.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
No, it's fine.
Get the spring ball first. Instead, after you get the gravity suit,
Go to
so he tells you to get the Nintendo strategy guide and then tells you what's wrong in it.
Yeah, he copy edits it a little. And then he adds just text to beat a boss.
There, yep.
If I'm randomly blacking out while playing Super Metroid, this is going to be really helpful.
Yeah, this is not exactly a hint there.
See here, and then use the grappling beam to make a hole in the ceiling.
Okay.
Jump up through the hole to get ready to do some serious space
jumping. Jumping through the hole, not pictures.
Space jumping, edited out.
Just forget it. Okay.
Just trust us. You got it.
Moving on.
Nailed it.
Space jump up the wall as high as you can.
George, just wall jump.
This is great.
Press the jump button
it's
again.
Easier, George.
Are you sure you want to give me hints on Super Metroid, George?
Keep gradually jumping higher and higher.
Yeah, he's worse than you.
I know, seriously.
After waiting for a helpful little robot to clear the way,
so much of this video is for getting a completely useless item in Super Metroid.
Yeah, no, totally.
Only two major items are left. The plasma beam in the upper section of Meridia, and the screw attack in the lower...
Hey! Your guide sucks, George! Stop it!
You've met Ridley before. He haunted you at the beginning...
And then here's a reminder in case you forgot who Ridley is in this very long game.
Again in the lower reaches of Norfair.
So how do you beat Ridley, George?
Before the mother brain. Use anything and everything on this mark.
Just use everything.
Oh, just use,
yep.
Use
and here's
shit.
Everything listed.
Super missiles and the charge beam.
Right.
Charge
beam.
After you beat Ridley, go through all the maps in the Metroid book to look
I
for the energy tanks you couldn't get before.
I can't take this guide anymore!
Areas in the game to get them.
And by the way,
save
your game, dude!
So he. And then enter the room I'm glad he got all the rest of the energy tanks off camera.
He mentions, too, you use a strategy guide to find them, because he can't help you with that.
The baby Metroid returns in Turian, but all grown up. Your reunion is not a happy one. For some unknown reason, the Metroid sucks away all of your energy, except for one tiny
I kind of feel like that watching George's reviews.
Weird.
Weird! He didn't get the story of Super Metroid at the end. It somehow went over his head.
And then morph into a ball and pass through the hole.
And remember to get hit by everything.
Yeah, just stand there. Don't even bother dodging things, whatever.
Just stand
there.
Yep.
Shoot the brain itself. After this battle, surprise, surprise, the mother brain attaches to a body and becomes the ultimate
this, he's doing this like an excited 8-year-old telling his parents about Super Metroid.
Right, yeah.
And then the brain comes up from the ground attached to a body.
What the heck?
That's weird.
Weird. Yeah, in this part...
I mean, yeah, the game's kind of autopilot here, so...
Yeah, so here he just basically shows you the ending for no reason, which obviates your need not only to watch this video, but also to have spent money on the strategy guide for it.
Of course.
Metroid comes flying in and clings to the alien's head with
and there's George Wood's book report on Super Metroid.
Real half-assed book report.
Energy,
yeah.
And its own energy, the Metroid now has hyper.
I would love to hear him narrate over the other M intro too, like the computer graphic version of this.
And then Samus gave a thumbs down. What was up with that?
The Metroid could have run away before the brain had time to recover.
Wait, what is this, your fan fiction on Super Metroid?
Hyper beam. With this awesome weapon power, you can finally beat the mother brain once and for all.
Hooray.
Now it's time to evacuate.
He's gonna fuck up the shine spark, isn't he?
Yeah.
When you get to
a
path, choose the lower path. You only have 3 minutes to blow this joint.
Well, 3 minutes is a lot of time, unless
of course, George would save the animals.
Of course.
What a loser.
Lastly, head for your spaceship and get the heck out of this place. Now sit back and watch the conclusion of Super Metroid.
And I think the conclusion of Super Metroid is maybe where we want to wrap things up. Around.
Absolutely.
So,
yeah.
We'll let that run for a little bit. Thanks for coming. We have a Q&A portion now and such. So
does anyone have any... Since we're going to see the end of Super Metroid, we're going to see what George's completion
time was. Right.
And also his item collection percentage. So any bids in the audience about time or item completion? 9 hours. I heard 9. 10. 12.
12 hours.
Okay. 16. 18. 14 hours. You don't 14 have hours. Such little faith in George.
Seriously.
I mean, come on. Maybe he did sub 30 minutes. You never know.
Only without the masturbation.
Mostly.
Oh, if anybody on camera needs it, reminds me of DSP. I didn't just say the word masturbation for no reason. Mm-hmm. But
so I guess the panel was completed successfully.
Yeah. 49.
If you beat Super Metroid in under 10 hours, you did really good. I think it's a new world record. What about item collection percentage?
That's the fun part of the panel. Yeah, that's... Guess item collection percentages.
We're doing the interactive portion now.
10 hours. You got to have picked up at least.
60, 30. 5%.
5%. And... 86. Now, you say that's good, but he did buy a strategy guide, remember?
That's true. So if you follow George Wood's advice, you'll be plus.
Yeah.
B plus.
And we'll see you next mission.
Seems generous.
Absolutely. Up the air. We'll leave it up. Why not?
Yeah. Give a little plug.
There you go. You're welcome. Mm-hmm. He's like, get that off air.
All right. All right,
so.
So anybody got some questions? We got a mic up here. Got a guardian with a mic wandering around. Somebody in the back.
Some guy with a selfie stick, I think. I mean, you can go to whoever. I was just pointing out that he had that. It worked.
That guy in the back. Hey, whatever. He was the first one to wave.
Yeah, go for it.
How's it going?
Hey, it's okay.
Yeah, it's been better.
So, question. Is it true that wife streams have saved your marriage, Slowbeef?
No, they've heard it, really. Mm-hmm. If you didn't know, I decided to show my wife video games, and we stream together, and she doesn't play video games at all. Hated Undertale, by the way. Like, hated it. It was the weirdest thing. I liked Undertale a lot, so, like, when Napsabluke was on screen, I was like, oh, that's going to be cool. And she was like, you know, honestly, it's the same shitty graphics room by room. I don't even know. And you're acting like I'm in for a big treat. So
we were going to have our panel be a cuddle puddle, but his wife talked us out of it.
Yeah, basically. But anyway, it's saving our marriage. We get to spend time together, and I get to play video games, which is more important. But
y'all seem to have a pretty good chemistry. Have y'all, like, met before?
My wife and I?
Yeah.
Once or twice.
Yeah, you met before? Okay.
Yeah, no,
y'all seem familiar.
She was on some, like, marry me website, you know, that kind of thing, so.
Marryme.com?
Yeah, you know.
And, Diabetus, when are you going to retsupray a wife stream?
You fucking better not.
I think I have to get married first before that happens.
No? Thank you. Oh, I have something for you if you want to come up.
Yeah, we got some giveaways.
Yeah. I should have asked. Are you a PC game? Do you have a Steam account?
Yeah.
All right, good.
Because otherwise we'd kick you out.
We have 30 copies of Five Nights at Freddy's 1, so you can start your Let's Play career. Yes. Actually, that's just a $20 Steam credit.
Oh, thanks.
Sure. Who the fuck's next? I'll let you decide, Guardian guy. That guy right by you here.
Follow your heart.
If Mike Dawson threw a ring to John Mayer, would he catch it?
Ooh. That's like, wow. It's like an insignificant force putting an unrecognizable object. And I don't know if you noticed, we have a podium with a picture of Mike Dawson that Dr. Strangelove printed for us up here up front. So
oh, nice.
Thank you for that. Do you want to use the podium and stand up? No, all right. So
I don't feel important enough for that.
Come on up if you have a Steam account, by the way. All right. Sure. Thank you.
I've been watching you guys for quite a while, actually.
Oh, why?
I'm sorry. Well, do you want to talk about it? You okay?
Not really. Yeah. So,
what's
but,
up?
I had a quick question then. This said, since Slowbeef, you now have a family and everything, how did that actually like work since you're doing RoosterTeeth and you're still doing that? How the heck are you even keeping up with family?
I thought you meant how did the family work. It's like, wow.
Oh, shoot.
Glad we waited until the end of the panel. Let me tell you how. All right. It's not easy. I do, you know, I have grad school. I have my job. I have the family. I have the RP channel and my.
Why are you crying?
I basically don't sleep. When I go away to these conventions, I'm not even joking with you, the sleep is what I look forward to the most.
Yeah.
So it's awesome. And this time, 6 a.m. flight to get here, so I didn't even get sleep last night. It was awesome.
So Sylvia's wife, if you're watching, he just said he's very happy to be away from you.
Yes.
Yeah.
She texted me that, too. I felt, no, I'm getting that. If you have a Steam account?
Sure.
Is that a yes?
Sure.
Sure. Yeah. No, there you go.
I'll make one right now.
There you go.
Oh,
wow. Look at that.
If you could do me the favor.
We're going to be doing signing and stuff like right outside after this if you want. Just because I don't have a Sharpie on me.
Okay.
All right. I came not prepared at all. Who's next?
So you guys have been doing this for how long?
Too
long. Like
8 years?
Yeah, 8 years we've been doing
this. How long
do
you guys think you'll continue doing RoosterTeeth and Let's Plays in general?
Today is, after today.
Yeah, this is it. Yeah, the panel.
This convinced me to.
Yeah, more or less. No, I don't know. I mean, honestly, too, like, I don't see an ending in particular anytime soon, I guess, you know.
Speak for yourself.
Okay. No, I mean, you know, my wife's cool with it and stuff, so, you know, whatever. Hey, we'll just keep doing it as long as, until I get too old, I guess, and then hand over.
We'll be in a retirement home together,
and then
making videos.
Sell you the channel for $1.5 million so I can achieve my dream of 9/11 Part 3.
Right.
No.
Very ambitious.
Oh, and if you want. We got, how many more of these we got? Six more.
Second birthday gift from my cousin.
There you go.
Nice.
Boom.
Uh-huh.
You just got.
Well, I mean, it's yours.
It's, yeah, exactly. You can choose to give it to him or not.
No.
He needs it because Steam won't let you have friends.
Okay, I don't need to. No, I'm just kidding. Good.
They won't let you have friends unless you have at least two USD in your account.
Gotcha, gotcha, gotcha. That's how my friends work, too.
Interesting. Yeah.
I somehow can't count, and I still have six left, so okay. That works. Who's next?
So with this brand spanking new King's Quest game that just came out, are you guys planning on doing anything with that?
Maybe.
Is it bad?
I wouldn't know.
I'm willing to give it a shot.
I mean, we tried King's Quest 7 the one time, but that...
It was really slow, yeah. So
sure.
I like to say never say never because, you know, maybe we'll dip in that well again, possibly. In fact, maybe you've given me the idea to, sir. What's your name? Jeff? Jeff, take a Steam card to that. Say thanks for that. Pretend I just didn't give it to five other people, too. Sure thing.
Hey, how's it going? I was wondering if you were still going to try to attempt... I liked 1 and 2, but I didn't know if you were going to do Dungeon World 3.
Wait, I'm sorry, what, 3?
Yeah, Dungeon World.
Oh, Dungeon World, yeah.
Part 3.
I keep saying yes, and then it never happens.
It's the whole time thing.
Well, I think, yeah, we could probably set aside some time. We should probably should have done it today, actually. Let's do it right now. Is there a panel after this? No? Good. Perfect.
You'll have 4 hours to spare.
So basically, I'll answer it the way I always answer it, which is yes, I would love to do another Dungeon World episode.
Yeah, I would too. It was a lot of fun.
It really was. Mm-hmm. I didn't think I'd like pen and paper RPGs and such like that, but I really liked that one. It was very social.
Mm-hmm.
Very cool stuff.
Very cash.
Did you get your Steam card, Jeff? Okay, good, okay. Or person who asked the Dungeon World question. Yep.
How are you doing?
I don't know. Sorry, I could use a coffee or like a water. Do you have water?
No.
Okay, that's good. I wouldn't just take it either way, because that would be weird, but...
So my question is when are you going to submit a Arrival to Hell challenges for Arcade Pit?
Arrival in Hell is an old Flash game we did with this Australian guy. And
the challenges make the grottiest, piss-stainedest toilet you can.
It really had this great animation, so to speak. You know, they actually have an HD remake of Arrival in Hell. I mean, by HD, I mean they redrew some stuff, and that was kind of it. But one of my favorite things is we had this old... you remember Death Trap?
Yeah.
It was this old Flash game where this guy did. The creator of Death Trap came in. We made fun of it the whole time. The creator came into our comments like, oh my God, I made this piece of crap like years ago. So he was really happy we got to do that. So
nice.
Thank you for your question. Take a card.
Any card.
You got three left.
Make it three good questions.
Right. Three great questions. I mean, we'll do questions afterwards. You just won't get shit. Sorry.
Yeah.
I'm not fucking made of money here.
Hello.
I had a question for Slowbeef.
Hi.
Hi. How was it when you and your daughter first experienced Pokemon for the first time?
We experienced what for the first time?
Pokemon.
Pokemon. Actually, my daughter hasn't experienced Pokemon yet.
You're a terrible father.
She's not. I am, but for other reasons. No, she's not, and she's not going to. I experienced it the first time. I did. I think we both played Pokemon for the first time.
I didn't play it.
Oh, on my stream, you were watching it, but you would never played it either.
Right.
And I did the whole Nuzlocke thing, and it turns out I am fucking terrible at Pokemon. There's like types and stuff, like elements that you can't match and all that, I think. But it's like weird, like water works on fire, but not the other way around.
Nope.
So to answer your question, I'm too humiliated to show my daughter Pokemon.
Sorry.
No, I'd like to play that again, actually. I would show it to her. Here's my thing with my kid, too. I don't really want to like push her into games or anything like that. It's just like something where if she ever sees me play and wants to like know more about it, I'll destroy my cable modem and throw it into a volcano and then show her, you know? So that kind of thing could work.
Safe bet.
Well, thank you for your question. Do you want a Steam card? Come on up.
Two left
after this.
So since you both seem to have a secret deep animosity against each other, who mm-hmm.
It's true.
It's not really so secret, honestly. It's very out in the open. Thank you very much for your question, by the way.
Who are your favorite people to do retro plays with besides each other?
Devo is. I really like Devo. Ty Tuesday, you answering this question.
CherryDoom in the
Cherry
audience.
CherryDoom in the audience. Yeah. Well, I mean, you know, it's okay. I won't not CherryDoom. no. I don't know. I guess, you know.
You did a lot of that guest stuff a little while ago.
We used to have, like, a lot of guests on. We had, like, Mike and Ray from RoosterTeeth on, which is how we actually met them and kind of, like, got this whole thing going and stuff. It's called networking. The 9/11 guy mastered it, so we should, too.
Follow his example.
I like to bring in new people and things like that. I remember somebody got really mad at me once because I used to do these things on the channel called Live from Twitch where I'm just like, call in, you know, whatever. I'll play a video game and shit. One guy's like, no, RP is just you and Diabetus and that's it. And I'm like, okay, I guess you own the channel now, pal. Thanks. you'd also know when we've always brought other people in. So take that, YouTube commenter. I don't even remember, I guess. Bang.
Nailed it.
Whoa. Oh, whatever. Thank you for fucking Steam card.
One more card left.
One more card left.
Also here, my brother wanted me to give you
these. Oh. Oh, thank you.
This says you.
Did you not? Okay, thank you so much. Let's do this. This is like one of those unboxing videos, but
yeah, those are always so much fun to watch.
I know. Oh shit! Actually, I do like this a lot. Wait a minute. Oh my god! Hold on. This is awesome. This is a. I'll show you what this is. So that is a big Snatcher T-shirt, which is. Look at that! Holy shit! I'm putting that on right now.
I have a Solaire here, praising the sun.
Hey!
Very nice.
That's awesome. Thank you so much. Who gave that to us? You?
Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you so much. I really appreciate this. This is awesome. Wow. And. The best thing is now, too, since I didn't want to expose my chest to all of you, I get to wear two shirts in the hot Austin sun. So perfect. Woo! This is really fucking cool, though.
Wonderful.
What?
If I can wear a lab photo game, you can wear that.
That's true, yeah. Yeah, I know all the cosplayers in the room are like, fuck you.
yeah, thanks a lot, though. That was really nice.
10-minute warning. That's okay. We got one more thing to give away. We got... Yeah, hey, how are you?
Hey. So have you mastered the dad joke yet?
Have I mastered the dad joke?
Yeah.
No. No. I'm just good at doing bad jokes on my own, really, even before I was a dad. So we're getting there.
Been training for years.
She doesn't understand what I'm saying, really. So, you know, whatever. That's just my excuse for starting. Come on up and get a Steam card. Hello, Steam. I'm dad. Is that how that goes? Is that the...
Out of Steam cards and all the hands go down.
Everyone just leaves. Yeah. But we do have answers to questions.
Yes.
If your kids end up being interested in gaming, what games would you like to share with them?
Not Undertale.
Perhaps PT.
PT, right. I don't know, truthfully. It's like one of those things I feel weird about, like, you gotta play Snatcher and Police Knots over and over again or some shit. I don't know.
I translated this.
What's a good game for kids, you think, to win
Undertale.
Them all?
Undertale!
Five Nights at Freddy's really fucked them up. Yeah. we're not going anywhere. No. Yes, I don't know, honestly. I guess it's just going to be a matter of what they still look like they're into. Maybe I'll get them into AGDQ early and things like that and show them like Bullet Hells and tough games like that.
Mario Maker would be good for kids.
Or things you can speedrun, actually. I'm sorry, Mario Maker?
Yeah, seems like a good kid game.
Oh, yeah, okay. I actually have still never played it.
Fosters the creativity.
Oh, nice. Yeah. Okay, yeah, we'll do that. Thanks for the tip. Why don't you be the dad for a while?
Chain chomps everywhere. Yeah.
What else we got?
Yes.
Is this on?
Yes.
Whatever happened to the Amazon Guardians of Eden run?
Oh yeah, we should do that. We have a million like half finished things we should back to. Yeah. The long player in that situation ended up like doing really weird shit that like out of order and stuff, so it was kind of tough to talk over. So it was one of those things where I'm like, I should play over that again, and then I never did. But and I know someone offered to play it for me, but yeah, we never went back to it, and we totally should. Thanks again for reminding me of another personal failure. Hey, who's
Somebody,
You had Pat from Super Best Friends play on your podcast. Have you ever considered doing a one-off with the Super Best Friends?
A one-off video for the channel?
Yes.
I have considered that, yeah. So actually, Matt submitted footage for me. I don't know, I gave them footage of me and my daughter for a wrestling promo for a series they did. So Matt gave me something for a secret project I'm working on. And this is true. So keep in mind, this is a favor he does for me or whatever. I talk to them every now and again. He got it back to me in like 2 weeks. I asked Beatus for a 30-second clip months ago. Never got back to me. I brought the camera just for it, but even in the meantime, I found someone else to do it, so fine.
You got to pay to play, man.
Yeah. I also had Willie watch me play Alien Soldier once on my channel, which was fun, and because I love Alien Soldier. But yeah, I would definitely love to do more stuff with those guys. They're really cool people.
Mm-hmm. They were actually going to come to RTX, but didn't work out with their travel arrangements, unfortunately.
Yeah. I was about to say that, then I'm like, maybe I shouldn't bring that up, and then he just did, so okay, yeah. Mm-hmm. No, I don't know.
They couldn't make it.
I know, they couldn't, yeah. Anyway. Next caller.
Hey guys, I'm sure you get this a lot, but ever since I saw A Day in the Life of DSP, I have been this huge ironic DSP fan. I hope he never stops. So besides the time
you're not alone.
Besides the time he masturbated on stream, I was wondering how closely you guys have kind of kept up with him.
Let me tell you a story.
That was really his masterpiece, his masturbate piece. Yeah.
Darkside Phil actually hadn't blocked me on Twitter. How much time do I have? 5 minutes? Okay, until this moment, right? So he did a video about Toby Turner. I miss. And he basically, the story he told was that back in the day, Toby Turner had an ad that appeared on his video. And he tweeted to Turner like, hey, what the fuck are your ads doing on my videos? And Turner tweets back like, oh, I'm sorry about that, man. And DSP wrote back, that's okay, hey, can we bring this to DMs and talk about it? And then Turner completely snubbed him because he's like a nobody. But basically, he had this 20-minute video, and I'm watching it on the speaker with my wife, and he goes, so yeah, basically, Toby Turner fluffed me. And my wife goes, wait a minute, isn't fluffing when, like, in porno, when they keep an actor erect before the scene? And I go, holy shit, it is. He meant snubbed, but he said fluffed. That's awesome. So I tweeted him that, and he blocked me. This was like 3 months ago, but yeah. And then he got caught jerking off on stream, and we included it in the slide.
Who do you think was fluffing him?
I think he was doing it himself, honestly. All right, so who else we got?
Got a couple minutes left?
We have 4 minutes, according to this clock. I mean. You don't have to duck, it's just a blue screen. There's nothing to...
All right, so I gotta know, what is the shittiest ending to any sort of book, movie, or video game you've ever had to sit through?
Oof. God, Mighty Number 9. 4.5 fucking hours of credits. And there's a rap, by the way.
Is that not an exaggeration, 4.5 hours?
It is, really? Apparently. I saw there was a YouTube video somebody put up, and it's like 417, I think. But because they thank each and every Kickstarter backer.
Like one at a time?
It's not like Inafune comes out and says, like, thank you, you know, Weed Lords 420, thank you, you know, whatever. Yeah. But, like, it just keeps scrolling and scrolling and scrolling. But there's a rap a la, like, his world.
4.5 hour rap?
No, I think that part ends.
That'd be awesome.
And I was streaming it, and then it just cut out right at that started. And I'm like, yeah, you know what? That's for the best. So that's up there. Seriously?
Yeah. Either people didn't submit their names, or they had their names removed.
That's kind of awesome.
I'm sorry, my name was in there.
I'm not. It was great to watch a train wreck. What else we got? We got 2 minutes, so this might be the last one.
All right.
End it good.
Sorry. Whenever you go on Arcade Fit before each round, what were you really expecting for it to go like?
To lose.
I didn't hear a word of that.
What were we expecting coming into it? Is that your question? Yeah.
Into this panel?
No, going to Arcade Pit.
Oh, going to Arcade Pit? I was expecting to kick some serious ass, and this anchor friggin' dragged me down. Ridiculous. But
what are video games?
What are video games?
Never played one.
Still got 2 minutes. I mean, really like a minute 30. It's like time stopped, but.
Would you ever go back to any of the successful Kickstarters that you've lampooned that actually came out with a game or something and actually play that game?
No.
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 We're good.
We're good, actually. Speaking of we're good, I think that's about our time. So I want to thank you all for coming out.
Yeah, so...
Oh, it wasn't a selfie stick. It was a Zulu-Zela.
So we didn't have an autograph sesh this year, but we are going to go hang out in the corner back
yeah,
here.
So if anyone
wants to
say hey,
chat briefly, we'll be back there. So thank you all for coming.
Thanks.
Bye-bye.